Which Victor do I prefer?
I mean, I will let the answer, I will let you guess, all right?
Which Victor do I prefer? Anyway, I like both. I fell in love with the LOR design for Victor, obviously, because he is my favorite champion to play there together with Zoe. But as a guy with a cosmic horror YouTube channel, I also quite like the Eldritch Abomination that Victor has turned into. I actually thought it was like, it fit the story really well. I liked it a lot. So I don't really have a preference. We play Runeterra, so we live in a world we can have both at the same time. Right? If we ever get the new Victor, he'll just be like Victor Illuminated. Peak. Okay, I'm gonna skip the deck for now. Wait, is that 8 cards? Is it 10? Maybe I'm... No, I think it's actually 9. I think I'm coping. Okay. Before I say anything about this, I'm just gonna read the abilities first so we can guess how well these cards in the deck actually synergize. So let's open this right here. Let's go full screen. All right, so this is Victor, new PvE champion. 1-star, common. Allies with augment have +1/+1. So this is just like, if I have the augment keyword, I get +1/+1. Lame. March of the Machines, epic, +1 starting mana. When you summon a created unit, grant it augment. I like this a lot. This is kind of cool. It's like, okay, so I'm doing the printing, I'm drafting created cards, and when I play them, they have +1/+1, plus synergy with my future created cards. It's good, it's better. Look at me, I'm spirit, literally. Oh my god, okay, banger, actually. It's also a blue keyword, so his one star is just like, sometimes have spirit. Okay, now this technological leap, upgrade at 3 stars, allies with augment have +1/+1, so still the spirit. Your augments grant an additional +0/+1. So because augment is get +1/+0 whenever you play create a card, that now becomes when you play create a card, get +1/+1. So let's say I play the cat. I'm taking the cat as an example for no particular reason. I'm not taking the cat as an example because of their left keyword here. The cat has augment. So I play a 3-mana 2/4. I play a create a card. It becomes a 3/5. I mean, it's like, it's fine. I don't think that's great. I don't think that's horrible either. It's completely whatever. I think, once again, the nuance needs to come from actually playing the game and playing creative cards in an interesting way. But the rest of the power most likely comes from the 4, 6-star and his relic. So let's look at that as well. Spellburn is the 4-star. Now, we looked at this very briefly yesterday. I just went over it and I wanted to say or give my thoughts on the next day so I can have a little more time to let it simmer, you know, make sure I do right by my favorite champion. I was like, Spellburn, I don't really love it, but it kind of does give him a lot of different angles because of all the free spells you create. And Spellburn makes it really easy to play Packed Powder on Victor. If you have a 4-star Victor, I think Packed Powder might become best in slot. There is more to it. His 5-star is get an extra mana gem. But his 6-star is when you create a when you play a created spell or unit, copy it. People say that this is Mirror Mage, but that is not entirely true. Because Mirror Mage says spell or follower. This implies that you will double up on champions. So the obvious thing here is going to be you get the legendary power level up. You shuffle 10 level 2 champions into your deck. With this, you play them, you get 2 of them. Even more interesting is playing Echoing Spirit and Pack Powder. If you play Echoing Spirit and you play a spell on turn 1, you will have Packed Powder, you play your Echoing Spirit Victor, you will have double Victor on the board for 2 mana. Right? It's two mana, yeah. So you would need to play a one mana spell, and then you have two victors. This is really fun, I think. It's, like, super simple, but doubling up on cards creates, like, the most bonker scenario sometimes, especially if you can do it on champions. Like, champion printers have always been one of my favorite ways to play, because it's just, like, you completely break the game with it, right? It's like one of the premier ways of breaking Runeterra. So, we have one more thing that is a very important piece of the puzzle, and that is his relic. Let me find that. This is the perfect hex core. Epic, power, round start, create a hex core upgrade in hand. Your hex core upgrades have stopwatch and can upgrade any ally. So they are burst speed, and you can target your own allies with them. So, becomes pretty good with Yuumi, because Yuumi will have a way to activate Fade every round. Becomes pretty good with Kai'Sa, because you will have more keywords. But for Victor specifically, what happens is, this is created. So if you have a 6-star, this will also get doubled up. So that makes it like 0 mana for free, always activate spell burn. So I think Packed Powder, his Relic, and Echoing kind of guarantees that Victor basically levels on turn 1 and you have two of them on board. Because you play this, actually you would have to play a unit then, right? That might actually be a little difficult. You need to have like a 1 mana unit on the board for this to work. Play your 1 mana unit, you play a perfect hex core on that unit, and then you play a created copy of Victor from Echoing Spirit, and then you get two more hex cores. And they get doubled. So because you play that one mana unit, this one gets doubled, and then you play Victor, you get another hex core. They also get doubled. That's 6 created cards. That's crazy, no? Great combo with Chosen. Chosen by the Stars could also be pretty good on Victor, yeah. Hex core upgrade starts with stopwatch. So it's not only from the item, it's also from this. Okay, so Victor looks really simple. I feel like there is a lot of nuance, but when you look at it, everything is like one line of text. Okay, if you have augment, it's basically also spirit. Oh, augment now gives an extra 1 health, so you just get a clean +1/+1, and your units grow really big. But then you have the 6-star, and that's also pretty simple. It's like, okay, just double up your created card, dude. Like, that's all it is. But that creates so many, like, interesting game states, I think. Like, from playing Mirror Mage, I could tell you that it does. It also makes drafting cards during an adventure really cool. And I think this is one of the most interesting things that Runeterra sometimes gets right. But not all the time, unfortunately. Sometimes you have a power, and it's unfortunate that you need to be 6-star for this, but Runeterra is at its best when you have a specific style of play that you're kind of forced into. Because even when you're forced into it, you still have like all these options because there are so many cards that do that one thing. Like, for example, Volibear. If you're playing Volibear, you want expensive units because they are Titanic, and you get to discount them. Even more interesting, though, is when you're playing Pike 6-star. Pike 6-star is when I attack, summon an ephemeral copy of a unit of the unit that's on top of your deck. Suddenly, you're inclined to just draft all the most expensive stuff because, well, if you're attacking with Pike anyway and you get to summon a unit for free, why don't they just put an Otacon in my deck, right? They are ephemeral, but actually, no, they're not ephemeral. With Pike, they're not even ephemeral. You just get them. You just get an Otacon if you want it. It's also with, I don't know, Janna. I guess Janna wants a lot of draw. You find a Sunken Temple with Janna and you say GG. It's going to be the same with Victor. It's really going to depend on how many creative cards you can find. Play creative Victor? Yeah, that's why I think Echoing Spirit is going to be really good on him. So going through the nodes, going through the adventure, and finding creative cards, super fun. Just that direction. And there are a ton of ways to create cards. So everyone is still going to look different while you are trying to maximize your way of playing. What about Oath of Guardians 6-star, 6-star, Victor 6-star? Yeah, I love it. Very, very cool. With Lilia, they are ephemeral. Oh, yeah, yeah. When Lilia plays a unit, they attack. Like, you get a create unit and they immediately attack. Yeah, that's true. Now, there are a lot of ways, a lot of really cool ways to play this. I'm going to be honest, this looks even simpler than Warwick. If we go to the star powers... okay, am I coping for this? Am I just, like, completely off? But I feel like this looks much simpler than what Warwick did already. But I feel like the roof on this is so much higher. Maybe I'm just Victor-coded and I see Victor and I fall in love. But this is kind of what I look for when I play Victor. This is how I want to play Victor. Let's go through the starting deck as well. Okay, so we have a Forge Chief. So that is the one man unit we were talking about. Having a one man unit is going to be important. It will depend on the way that you're playing, Victor. But if you have his epic relic, this Forge Chief or the Ballistic Bot is most likely going to be what you play your hex scores on. One of these two. Clump of Wumps, like, this card pisses me off. I'm honestly a little bit upset that this is in the deck again. It's like, why not just like a Conch or something, man? Why not, I don't know, Pharaoh's Financier? I guess they want to give you like a cheap creator card, but honestly, I'm so tired of this thing. I really am. Every single deck I see Clump of Wumps, I'm like, okay, really? There wasn't anything better? Like, this is why I want unique cards for champion releases. Like, here's how I feel, guys. The Rictus art is a little jarring. Yes. Ultimately, I don't care. I'm just happy that we get to play Ambessa with a new card. Like, yes, you know, this is clearly, like, this is not Runeterra art. But if you play a game this much, just having an interesting card in the deck is totally fine. But we have Clump of Wumps. Why can't they just, like, is it rotated? Oh, the boy's rotated. Why can't they just, like, I don't know, like, take this part. Like, only take this as a card. This. Like, make this a new card, you know? Like, here, put this as the art. This is, this is Freddy the Ferret. All right? This is Freddy the Ferret, and he is a 2-mana 2/2 as well. That says, play manifest a poison dart, mushroom cloud, or entrapment, or something. I don't know. this is the Womp Shaker. Yes, this is the Womp Shaker. Oh my god. Bro, can somebody edit this and put like the hand on it from Rat Shaker? Oh my god. I want to see that so badly now. Hold on. Just like this guy, and then like this. Hold on. Why can't I open this? Wait. And then like this. Just like a hand holding this guy like that. Oh yeah, we played this on stream yesterday and it was amazing. It will be on YouTube at some point. Man, this game was hilarious. I think this might have been the funniest game I played in 2024. All right, so we want to make the Womp Shaker. As simple as that. 2-mana 2/2, make a poison dart. And make a bursting backpack, poison dart, or entrapment in hand, or a stinky womb. I don't know, something like that. As simple as that. Just something new, man. Like, I don't know. I think it's really like just lame that we get another 2-mana 2/2. Yeah, I don't know if there's like any legal things that's going on that they can't just like take this piece of the art, because it's the same with also I'm going off on a bit of a rant here, but it's the same with this, right? Like, why couldn't they do that for this? Just take this area. This is the Rictus art. Like, why couldn't they just make this Rictus? Is that weird? I feel like they've done that before with some cards. Yeah, they have. Wait, they literally have. I know which one too. They've done it with this one. This guy. This is a card and this is a card. These are two cards. I feel like they could have easily done that with this too. They have budget cut, not card cut. All right, what is this, Marshall? Oh, sure. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, exactly. It looks clean, too. Like, this does not look jarring to me at all. This looks completely fine. If this was not even, like, if this was before budget cuts, I'd be like, okay, yeah, that's a real Runeterra card. That looks clean. That looks like it belongs in the Runeterra universe. There is nothing wrong with this. Oh, yeah, and they've done it here, too. Right, yeah. This and this. So there's at least two examples of this being done before. I feel like there must be a reasoning, because honestly, like, you can say what you want about the Runeterra team, but they're making the most out of all the tools that they have. 100%. They are squeezing every last drop of value out of the given tools that they have. 100%. So there must be a reason that this is not the card. There's got to be some legal reasons. I don't know what it is. Anyway, yeah, that's Clump of Wumps. That's how angry this card makes me when I see it in my PvE deck. Okay, so iterative improvement, fantastic. I love the discards in here. They give me a real printing cart in my printing champion deck. Oh, patch notes. All right, hold on. So I'm going to quickly finish the review on this, and then we'll open this. All right. So the last four cards, Boom Baboon, is a little weird, but the Flame Chompers will get augment because created cards get augment. So that will be a 1-3 Chompers, and you can buff it up by playing more created cards. That's honestly like pretty good, but there isn't any discard in this deck, which is like strange. yeah, I don't know. It's probably good. It's probably good enough. Neandroid is like a payoff card. Doesn't really do anything with created. Aftershock, same thing. It's just a 3-mana deal 3, I guess. Works with Spellslinger, Spellburn thing. Your four star. Mechanized Mimic is also a payoff card and already has augment. I guess it makes sense. Like, you have Victor as the payoff and the creation, right? There's always, like, in decks like this, there's always two angles. It's like, you need the cards that synergize and activate your, in this case, keyword. And then you need cards with that keyword. These are clearly the cards with that keyword. And everything else is kind of like the payoff. And Victor is both. Yeah, I mean, not bad. I don't really like the Aftershock. And I don't like Clump of Wumps at all. Everything else is pretty great. I wish they could replace Aftershock and this with something else. That's the only thing. Okay. Let us look at the patch 5.12 notes. They have just been released. So, log in to play patch 5.12 on December 4th at approximately 11 a.m. PT. That is 8 p.m. Central European time. So, that is right now, 8 p.m. Okay. New PvE champ. Okay, really fast. So this is also important to talk about because I completely forgot. We were supposed to get two new champions. We were supposed to get Victor and then plus one, a brand new champion. Could have been Victor V2, could have been Singed, could have been Mel, could have been Smeech, could have been the little Yordle girl that ran the brothel in season one. It could have been anything. We don't know. Thing is, that brand new champion has been delayed, postponed, because they want to add more polish. And I absolutely commend the Rune Terror team for that. I think that is the right choice. I like quality over quantity, and that is rough to say as a content creator, because I just want to put out, check out this new champion on my video titles as often as I can, but I deeply care about Rune Terror, and adding that extra level of polish and quality that we're used to is a big deal. So I am... Not command. I will not command the Rune Terror team. I would if I could. I would make them add Teemo Sixstar to the game. I would make them add another Victor to the game, another Fiddlesticks, but command. Yeah, not command. So it's been delayed. We don't know until when. It's pretty likely that next month we'll just get two PvP champions or two champions that were already in the game added to PvE instead. I don't know what exactly it means for them to add a higher level of quality on that new champion. It could be a level of animation, could be extra cards, could be voiceover. We don't know. We'll have to find out. But any extra level of polish will obviously go a very long way. So I'm excited to see what they do. And if it's possible, I would even love to see the before and after. Where it's like, okay, we were going to ship this, but we didn't to add this. And that also gives us kind of like an insight on how difficult it probably is to add any of that stuff. I feel like there's just like a lot of red tape when it comes to that, where it's just really difficult to just like call up the Singed voice actor from RK and be like, yo, can you do some of these voice lines and, you know, make them sound good as well? Over the phone is fine. Just say something. Try to not be too funny. Stay a little serious and we'll ship it. It's probably a little more difficult than that, but we don't know until we see it. Okay. Witness the rise of the glorious evolution as Victor joins the path of champions with a full suite of powers. And he doesn't even have glorious evolution as a card. Unbelievable. Okay, so we just went over this, the 5-star, the 6, the relic. Victor champion bundles. Celebration. 4-star, 5-star. Arcane Season 1 Revival Bundle. To celebrate the new season of Arcane, This bundle includes discounted legacy cosmetics offered during the first season release, available for a limited time. That's probably the gilded skins, like gilded Jinx, Vi, Jace, Echo, and Caitlyn. I think that was it. Oh, the actual arcane skins. Okay, so Vi and Jinx. Okay, that's possible too. I see. Okay. Also cool for the people that missed out. They're good skins. Gemstone series. This patch includes a new bundle series allowing you to unlock gradually increasing levels of gemstones. Okay, guys, I'm just going to say this right here. I know I'm a huge Runeterra simp and will. Gemstones are a scam, okay? Don't do this. Don't buy this. Please, pass up on the gemstones, okay? Save your money. Buy actual quality content. This is garbage. Just gotta say it. Okay. Change cards, new flavor text. We retroactively added flavor text to the following support cards, introduced Fiddlesticks and Bessa and Warwick to address player feedback. Holy! Public Execution, Cunning Sweep, Sundering Slam, Conscription, Rictus, Blood Hunt, Crowstorm, Shallow Siren, Dreadheart. Oh my god. Okay, right. If you're watching, you could have contacted me. I would have written all of these for free, okay? I could go here like Nightmare. This is like nightmares are what I used to have when Fiddlesticks wasn't in the game. False Friends. Everyone who had the possibility to add Fiddlesticks to the game, but didn't actually do it, was a false friend. Baleful Seeker. Me balefully seeking for Fiddlesticks in Runeterra. I can go on. I can go on. They're listening. I hope so. Next time, I got you, Riot. I'll do it for free. Changed Emporium offers. Comp patch 5.12. Portal Accelerator will no longer be available in the Emporium, and instead Shock and all... Okay, hold on. Wait, that's so funny. Because Portal Accelerator and Shock and all are the best relics on Fiddlesticks if you want to just slam dunk any single adventure. You equip Portal Accelerator for impact and Shock and Awe, and you just spam one drops and you literally mill the entire deck on turn one. These are the Fiddlesticks relics. That's hilarious. I think Shock and Awe is like really, really good, but only on like two champions. That being Fiddlesticks and Misfortune if you have her 6-star. The rest, it's probably not great. So, changed bundle offers. Champion-specific bundles are intended to run for 6 months in a feature store. In patch 6.1, one patch out from this release, we will be taking down a number of bundles that have been live for 6 months or longer, including all Celebration, 4-star, and 5-star bundles associated with these fellows. Okay. If you like these champions, pick them up now. Starting with this patch 5.12, ranked Eternal Queue will open. This means both the ranked standard and Eternal Queues will stay alive. That means that in a month from now, we're going to have another rotation. And hopefully, we can get rid of the absolute cringe fest that has made me upload like 3 PvP videos in the last 3 months. It was that bad. Ezreal is back. I think it's just Ezreal, most of all. Ezreal is back. That should say enough, honestly. Yeah, this rotation was worse than anything else in the game. It was really bad. I love Ezreal. Nick. Listen, Nick, you make fantastic art. Nick made this. Nick literally made this art. But this guy has some of the worst takes on the goddamn planet. And I know because I play Among Us with him like every week. Nick, you're great, but your takes are horseshit. They are not good. All right. I think Nick used to be a mod, but okay, hold on. I'm gonna put Nick to work involuntarily. I think you were a mod at some point and I accidentally removed it. All right, get back to work, Nick. Oh, you are a moderator. Okay, never mind. Well, get to work, Nick. And don't talk back to me about Ezreal. Okay, anyway. And lastly, we have some bug fixes. Fix an issue where the Lux encounter in a 6.5 early soul adventure could cause slowdowns during animations and before enemy actions. Yeah, basically like just lag all the way through. Literally. Spider Axe is uploading the flavor text. Okay. We can look at those afterwards. Fixed an issue where the card's public execution and Bessa's public execution, Warwick and Warwick level 2 could target allies despite their text specifying enemies. Oh, okay. It just says Warwick. I was thinking about Bloodhunt. I actually want at least one encounter because Warwick could kill my own ally. I don't. Yeah, this is actually a nerf. I mean, public execution? Isn't that like the deal 6? If something is stunned or attacked or something? I think this one matters less, but with Warwick, it's actually a nerf. Yeah, Warwick should... Like, honestly, it would kind of be more flavorful if Warwick could just attack an ally. Fix an issue where Vex level 2 double gloom that was applied to her by the enemy. This has been in the game since Vex's release. Oh, it's a strike rally? Ah, I see. Okay, that's a huge nerf then. Yeah. That's a really big nerf. I remember getting destroyed because I had level 2 Vex and my opponent gloomed me or something. But this was like a while ago. Fix an issue where surprise summoning used the wrong icon. I don't remember this. Fix an issue where Aatrox's card art was offset when in the back row of a match. It's no longer Shytrox. Yeah, I'm sure there's got to be like an example of it somewhere. But the card art for Aatrox was completely decentered, where he was like his face. It was like that meme of God, who was it? This is actually not the best example. But basically this one. This was like Aatrox. Okay, so that is it. We don't have any news on the new update to Legends of Arcane. Except that there are new rewards. Oh, wait. New adventure slot rewards added to the Legends of Arcane event. So does that just mean you have to beat them with different regions? Three more? Damn. The rewards were insane, by the way, from this. Is that a red switch keyboard? Yes, it is. Another month where Volley 6-star is unsolved. What was the problem with it? Not Karma. Oh my god, we have to do more Karma. No. Okay, but Karma was like actually horrible though. Okay, and then we have this. So these are some of the flavor texts. Sundering Slam, the battlefield is no place for mercy. Like the wolf, we strike at the first opportunity. Like the desert fox, we watch and listen and range far. I dreamt of battle. We were on the brink of victory until it arrived. Men fell, others fled. I couldn't stop its scavenging. I fear it was an omen. It was a beast. Okay. Honestly, I'm just kind of interested in the Fiddlestick stuff. The nightmares will always chase your light little dream, but you shine through the burls, so always I will find you. Little dream, where have you gone? Like, okay, reading this, I'm honestly like, it's a bit bittersweet because I feel like when you look at this art, it's like kind of obvious that Fiddlesticks was meant to come to PvP, and then because of Riot cutting the budget, he's only in PvE. Like, don't get me wrong, I think Fiddlesticks is fantastic in PvE, but having him also in PvP, that would have been a dream. God damn it, Riot. That scarecrow seems to be doing the very opposite of scaring the birds away. I'm starting to think it's full to the brim with birdseed. Huh. Yes, that must be what's inside it. I thought we had it handled till the first mound got dragged clean beneath the sand. That was no storm. Some monstrosities lurking in that desert. Nah, it's nothing. It's probably nothing. Chains burst from the ground. Sand blinded me. I heard the cries of man and beast alike, then silence. When their voices returned, something was wrong. Very wrong! One man, a 6-3 with Overwhelm and Deathless, seems right to me. This art is so good, actually, man. So, like, I've actually never looked at this. This is like the mouth. This is like the thing that's in the sand. And this part, that's the mouth. And the rest is like the body. I heard if you die in your dreams, you die in real life. Okay, that's nice. If you die in game, you die in real life. I made a new friend today, a mermaid. She wanted me to swim with her and offer to teach me. I'm sneaking out after supper to see her. All right, well, that guy's dead. That guy's entirely dead. Okay, so we can also maybe look at the battle pass. I don't know if it's here. Hold on. Oh, here we go. Okay. This is the battle pass. So, Platinum Vault, 40 Victor Fragments, 2 Greater Cosmic. So, going through this, I guess we have to pay attention to the fact that this was probably meant for 2 champions, but they had to take Fragments out for that champion. And then replace it with something else. So probably this, right? Because you would get like 40 Smeech fragments, but instead it's Platinum Vault. Are they gonna do what they did to League and gradually nerf the pass each time? Bro, this is Runeterra what we're talking about. Everything League does that's scummy, Runeterra basically does the opposite. Like, League of Legends ruins the hopes and dreams of all Victor players by reworking him into something that they don't like. Runeterra's like, nah, we got you. Here's an awesome new art for the Victor that you know and love. I'm telling you, man. League does something. For every bad thing that League does, Runeterra does something completely right. I'm just saying. Okay, so 500 Stardust, 10 Wild Fragments, Bronze Reliquary, Gold Fall. Okay, Bronze Reliquary. Okay, this is all kind of whatever. 10 Star Crystals is pretty good. I think you need like 40 to get a Mana Gem. The 5 star, I think. Gold Vault, 20 more Victor Fragment. That's 60 in total. 5 Cosmic Blessings. Reliquary. Platinum Vault. 1 Gold Star Vessel right here. It doesn't say the region, so this could be anything. So this is just like at least 20 Nova Shards for X region. 10 Nova Shards for Piltover. 1 Silver Star Vessel for Bandle City. Bandle City. Piltover. 1 Silver Star Vessel. What? Ionia and Bandle City? Okay. Interesting. I wonder if these were just picked at random. Teemo and Irelia? If we get Teemo, I'll settle for an Irelia. I somehow don't think we're getting any more Piltover champions for a little while, though. Sounds like, maybe they're adding Lulu to the game. Yeah. It's Ionia Smeech. Checks out. Platinum Vault, Wild Fragments. 10 more Nova Shards for Piltover. 1 Silver Star Vessel for Runeterra. Reliquary. Platinum Vault again. Major Gemstone Vessel. 1 Gold Star Vessel for Piltover. 1 Diamond Vault. I mean, it's pretty good. Lulu Illuminated. There you go. Rip Sarah, Path of Champions. Yeah, no, I don't think I would mind Seraphine that much. Like, she is the biggest abom. Okay, I'm actually just going to say it. I think Seraphine release might be top 5, if not top 3, most broken champions that we have ever had in Runeterra. It might honestly be really close to number 1. But if something is that broken, that could be pretty fun in Path of Champions, right? I also hope that if they add Seraphine to Path, they're not going to do like 2-2-2-2, like sets of cards, but just like one each. Kai'Sa number 1, not even close. I honestly think that like Seraphine is pretty close to that, but Kai'Sa is better. Yeah, sure. Kai'Sa is better. I don't think people realize like how disgusting Seraphine was on release. Good Seraphine can stay away from me. I dislike Seraphine, but I think her playstyle is pretty unique that she could be pretty fun in Path of Champions. I'm number 1 Seraphinator. Kai'Sa was the only time I nearly quit. I thought the Seraphine meta was worse than the Kai'Sa meta, personally. I don't know if you realize how disgusting Kai'Sa was. My opinion has never changed, and I've said this for like 2 years now. Almost 2 years. My least favorite meta of all time was Seraphine Ezreal. And then it's Blade Dance, and then it's Kai'Sa. What about Samira Fizz or Nami Lee Sin? Those were degenerate, but I don't think they were as degenerate. What made her so strong, though? Seraphine. Seraphine used to level after playing 6 new cards. Spells, right? 6 new spells. That was insanely easy. The thing is, she was nerfed from 6 to 9, but past the original 6, like the final 3 that you need to play become even harder, because they're kind of harder to like acquire, and they'll also most likely be lower quality. So it's like if you go from 6 to 9, that sounds like okay, only 3 more. But in reality, it's like it's almost like a double increase because new spells are just a little more like difficult to get in that sense than just playing 9 spells like Lee Sin. And Bar at 6 mana too. Yeah. Okay, that also made a pretty big difference. Bar. Okay, so that is the patch. We're not really getting any new adventures. We're just getting like the Legends of Arcane adventure with some added rewards, which I'm not complaining about. I'm always happy with some easier ways to upgrade my champions. I think Victor's going to be a lot of fun. So tomorrow, I am going to be live with Victor.
We're gonna play like level 1 Victor versus Aesol, I think, and then we're just gonna slowly upgrade him to 6-star. I will eventually get Victor 6-star 100%. I'm not letting my favorite champion sit and rot there. I gotta do him justice.